knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
Continuing with our examination of drugs that regulate cardiovascular function, vasoconstrictors are drugs that increase smooth muscular contractility in blood vessels, thereby increasing systemic vascular resistance and, by extension, blood pressure. As we learned in the tutorial on bronchodilators, we can appreciate how sensitive airflow is towards the luminal diameter of the respiratory system tissues. Understandably, this also applies to the cardiovascular system and blood vessels. Vasoconstrictors, or pressor drugs, are critical in emergency medicine due to the extent that hypotension, or low blood pressure, is considered to be an emergency that must be aggressively treated. The quantitative benchmark for hypotension is less than 90 millimeters mercury systolic pressure, the pressure experienced by the arteries while the heart is beating, or 60 millimeters mercury diastolic pressure, the pressure in the arteries in between heartbeats. The reason hypotension is important to treat rapidly and aggressively is due to blood flow dropping towards crucial organ systems such as the brain, kidneys, and heart. If the passage of blood in these systems is reduced for long enough, organ failure and death are possible. Hypotension can arise for a few different reasons. A few examples are as follows. Hypovolemia, a state of extreme blood volume loss from hemorrhage or drastic dehydration. Reduced cardiac output from conditions like heart failure or damage to the myocardium. And reduced sympathetic tone arising from sepsis or drugs that interact with the autonomic nervous system. Hemodynamics is a complicated topic, and although these drugs increase arterial pressure, if the organ's systemic pressure also increases, the blood flow towards the organ will remain the same. Fortunately, vasoconstrictors tend to increase blood pressure in blood vessels outside these critical organs more than within the organ systems themselves. As a result of this, circulation in these critical organs is increased down a pressure gradient. Now that we understand a bit about the background of these drugs, we can learn how different vasoconstrictors increase blood pressure. There are two main classes of vasoconstrictors: alpha-1 adrenoceptor agonists and vasopressin receptor agonists. We have discussed some adrenoceptors in previous tutorials, and thus may recall that the alpha-adrenoceptor 1 is most highly expressed in vascular smooth muscle. Like the other adrenoceptors, it is a G-protein-coupled receptor, which couples through the G-alpha-Q signaling cascade. This signaling cascade has been described at length in the tutorial on decongestants. But to summarize, G-alpha-Q signaling leads to increased intracellular calcium ions, leading to increased smooth muscle contractility, in turn leading to decreased blood vessel luminal area. In this context, alpha-1 agonist pressors, such as phenylephrine, are often administered intravenously in an emergency due to more appropriate fast-onset pharmacokinetics. The other class of vasoconstrictors, vasopressin receptor agonists, we have also encountered in the previous tutorial on volume-regulating drugs. A commonly used vasoconstrictor in this class is vasopressin. These are analogs of the natural peptide hormone, also known as anti-diuretic hormone. As we learned, this peptide is physiologically produced in the hypothalamus, released by the pituitary gland, and acts on the V2 vasopressin receptor on collecting duct cells of the nephron to increase the insertion of water-transporting proteins, known as aquaporins. This leads to an increase of water reabsorption from the renal system into the cardiovascular system. More fluid reabsorption understandably leads to increased blood pressure through increased blood volume. However, the V1 vasopressin receptor on blood vessels is also activated and contributes heavily towards vasoconstriction. V1 also signals through G-alpha-Q, which can compound with alpha-1 adrenoceptor agonists. Like all other drugs, use of vasoconstrictors needs to be carefully considered, and patients need to be monitored when used in the case of an emergency. This is because coronary arteries are susceptible to constriction, which may reduce blood flow to parts of the myocardium and cause angina, a type of chest pain. Use of vasopressin especially needs to be carefully monitored because it may constrict coronary arteries and increase the myocardium's overall need of oxygen due to increased arterial pressure. With vasoconstrictors now understood, let's move on to examine their precise opposite, vasodilators.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.